Good afternoon from St. John's Episcopal Church in Suffolk, Virginia, broadcasting from the Chapel Annex in Portsmouth, Virginia. We will be gathering for Evening Prayer Rite II this evening. The service itself will begin on page 116. Our Psalms for this evening are Psalms 114 and 115. And those will begin on page 756 and 757 of the Book of Common Prayer. There's also an order of worship for this evening, which is located in the description, link to which is located in the description. And the service begins on page 10 in that order of worship. Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Let the whole earth stand, tremble before him. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed. By what we have done and by what we have left undone, we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways. To the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Alleluia. The invitatory canticle this morning is O Gracious Light, found on page 118. O gracious light, pure brightness of the ever-living Father in heaven. O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed. Now as we come to the setting of the sun, and our eyes behold the vesper light, we sing your praises, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices. O Son of God, O giver of life. And to be glorified through all the worlds. The Psalms appointed for this evening are Psalms 114 and 115. We'll say the Psalms together. Hallelujah! When Israel came out of Egypt, the house of Jacob from a people of strange speeds. Judah became God's sanctuary, and Israel his dominion. The sea held it back, beheld it and fled. Jordan turned and went back. The mountains skipped like rams, and the little hills like young sheep. What ailed you, O sea, that you fled? O Jordan, that you turned back? You mountains, that you skipped like rams? You little hills like young sheep. Tremble, O earth, at the presence of the Lord, at the presence of the God of Jacob, who turned the hard rock into a pool of water and flint stone into a flowing spring. Psalm 115. together, not to us, O Lord, not to us, but to your name give glory. Because of your love and because of your faithfulness, why should the heathen say, where then is their God? Our God is in heaven. Whatever he wills to do, he does. Their idols are silver and gold, the work of human hands. They have mouths, but they cannot speak. Eyes have they, but they cannot see. They have ears, but cannot hear, noses, but cannot smell. They have hands, but they cannot feel, feet, but they cannot walk. They make no sound with their throat. Those who make them are like them, and so are all who put their trust in them. O Israel, trust in the Lord. He is their help and their shield. O house of Aaron, trust in the Lord. He is their help and their shield. You who fear the Lord, trust in the Lord. He is their help and their shield. The Lord has been mindful of us, and he will bless us. He will bless the house of Israel. He will bless the house of Aaron. He will bless those who fear the Lord, both great and small, together. May the Lord increase you more and more, you and your children after you. May you be blessed by the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. The heaven of heavens is the Lord's, but he entrusted the earth to its people. The dead do not praise the Lord, nor all those who go down into silence. But we will bless the Lord from this time forth forevermore. Hallelujah. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. A reading from the first letter to the Thessalonians. We also constantly give thanks to God for this, that when you received the word of God that you heard from us, you accepted it not as a human would, as a human word, but as that what it really is, God's word, which is also at work in you believers. For you, brothers and sisters, became imitators of the church of God in Christ Jesus that are in Judea. For you suffered the same things from your own compatriots as they did from the Jews. You killed both the Lord Jesus and the prophets and drove us out. They displease God and oppose everyone by hindering us from speaking to the Gentiles, so that they may be saved. Thus they have constantly been filling up the measure of their sins. But God's wrath has overtaken them at last. As for us, brothers and sisters, when for a short time we were made orphans by being separated from you, in person, not in heart, we longed with great eagerness to see you face to face. For we wanted to come to you. Certainly I, Paul, wanted to again and again. But Satan blocked our way. For what is our hope or our joy? What is our hope or joy or crown of boasting before our Lord at his coming? Is it you? Yes, you are our glory and joy. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The canticle this evening is the Song of Simeon on page 120, or page 14 in the order of worship. Lord, You now have set your servant free to go in peace as you have promised. For these eyes of mine have seen the Savior, whom you have prepared for all the world to see, a light to enlighten the nations and the glory of your people Israel. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. We will continue with the Apostles' Creed on page 120 together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you. And also with you. In the words our Savior Christ has taught us, we now pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. The suffrages this evening are suffrage B, on page 15 in the order of worship. We will chant the suffrage this evening. Your response after each bidding is, "We entreat you, O Lord," sung like this. "We entreat you, O Lord, that this evening may be holy, good, and peaceful. We entreat you, O Lord, that your holy angels may lead us in paths of peace and goodwill. We entreat you, O Lord, that we may be pardoned and forgiven for our sins and offenses. We entreat you, O Lord, that we may depart this life in your faith and fear, and not be condemned before the great judgment seat of Christ. We entreat you, O Lord, that we may be bound together by your Holy Spirit in the communion of all your saints, entrusting one another and all our life to Christ. We entreat you, O Lord." A Collect for Peace. Most Holy God, the source of all good desires, all right judgments, and all just works, give to us, your servants, that peace which the world cannot give, so that our minds may be fixed on the doing of your will, and that we, being delivered from the fear of all enemies, may live in peace and quietness. Through the mercies of Christ Jesus, our Savior. Amen. a colic for those who are sick and those who minister to them. Gracious God, source of life and health, Jesus came to our disordered world to make your people whole. Send your Spirit on those who are sick and all who minister to them, that when the sick enter your peace, they may offer thanks to your great name. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. A prayer for mission. Keep watch, dear Lord, with those who work or watch or weep this night. Give your angels charge over those who sleep. Tend the sick, Lord Christ. Give rest to the weary. Bless the dying. Soothe the suffering. Pity the afflicted. Shield the joyous. And all for your love's sake. Amen. We'll just say a prayer of St. Chrysostom together. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, he will be in the midst of them. Fill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in the believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia.